In this session, I'm going to talk about permissions. Business Central has a long list of standardized, out-of-the-box permission sets. And let's go take a look at them. I'm going to do a find for permission sets. And we're going to see a long list, as I mentioned, of permission sets as I start scrolling down. These permission sets, as I mentioned, are more high-level, general permissions that you would assign each individual user. So when they're using the system, that's going to control what they could access and what they can't access, or what they can transact or not transact. So for an example, if they're accounts payable clerk, you could give them D365 accounts payable. If it's receivables, D365 accounts receivables, etc., accountants and so forth. It's general, but still does the job. You may want to start off, what I would recommend is starting off with these general high-level permission sets, and then from there, work your way down onto maybe tightening it up a little bit. So for an example, the accounts payable, if you want to see what these permission sets are, you know, what's within it, I'm going to go to permissions, and it's going to show you for every table data what the user can or cannot do. So we'll see payment terms, they could read it, but they can't insert it. They can modify it and they could delete it, but they're not allowed to create any new ones. That's what this is telling me. So I could, on the payment terms that I would apply to the vendors, I could read it, I could modify, and I could delete, but I cannot insert. Okay? Currency code. This currencies means I could read currency codes. I can't insert one, but I could also modify it, but I also can't delete it, and so forth, right? So you get the concept of, you know, so this breaks down every single table name, if you will, that's associated within that permission set, and does a breakdown of what it could read, insert, modify, or delete. And these can be changed, but they cannot be changed on the standard permission set that's out of the box. For example, this. They won't let you change this one, but how you can do it is you're going to copy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this permission set, and I'm going to call it my AP. I click on OK. And what that's going to do, it's going to create a brand new permission set with all the existing permission sets that are already in there, those table data sets. And you'll see now my AP is user defined, meaning that somebody created their and defined their own permission set. I could go into permissions and you'll see now it's the same information, but now I could actually edit it. It's more of an editable view of it. So maybe in here for vendor, you'll see I could read it, but I can't insert. I can modify and delete, but maybe I want to give them, you know, insert permissions. So I'm going to change that to yes. But maybe I don't want them to modify the vendor invoice discount group, right? Maybe the discounts are fixed and you don't want them. Maybe you want to give them indirect access, meaning that they could read it through if it's indirect, it means that you could read it through another table, but you can't change it and so forth. It's like indirect access. And blank just really means no, right? So maybe, you know, you leave that blank and so forth. And you could go through each individual area, maybe sales line, right? Sale, the reason why you have sales line, sales header and sales line is because, you know, potentially if you do drop ships, they have to talk to each other. But if you don't do that, then we could easily just take off instead of saying, yes, I could insert a sales line. I could modify a sales line. I could take this off. And so forth. So this is how you tighten up the permissions, if you will. But that's based on a user-defined situation. Okay, but now I have a permission set that I define that better suits me and my users. Okay, the other thing we could do is create a user group instead of adding individual permissions to each user. So if I go into user groups, this is going to show me a bunch of, you know, within these user groups, you could combine multiple permission sets into one group. So again, for an example, if I do new, I'm going to do my group. Okay. All right. And within this my group, I could actually now add different permission sets. So what I typically want to do, if I'm not a super user and or have full access rights, then you do have to have basic. That's a given, unless you're a super or full access user. Otherwise, you have to have basic. Okay, so that's rule number one. And then from there, you could add any permission sets. Let's say, so I want my AP that I created. I maybe want some PayPal. And maybe I want to go down and I want some banking and so forth. So I'm going to add all the permission sets that I feel is valid for my user. And maybe there's a cash flow. Okay, so now I'm content. I see I got all the permissions that I feel I want to add to my user or user group, because now it's a group. So now how do I apply this to users? Well, now that's in the permission sets, I'm going to go to my users. Well, there's actually two ways of doing it. This, I go to my users and go to myself. And within the user group section, I could see that I have, if I start scrolling down, I go individual groups as it shows here, or because I created my group that has a variety of different permission sets in one group, if I click on my group and I tag off it, now I know, you'll see it automatically brought in all of the permissions that I applied to my group. So it automatically brought, see my AP, my cash flow, basic, banking, etc. Because I assigned all of these to one my group. So now I assign my user to my group. So now I only have to, I know what permission sets that I tested and created. So all I need to do is apply the user to my group. There is another way of applying users to user groups. So I'm going to go, I'm going to find user group. And if I go to my group again, down here, I can just click on this. And I could also add users, user group members. So you see I added myself already. But if I want to add more people, then I can just click on add users. And then I could add more individual users. And I could keep on adding users to my group as I see fit. So as soon as I keep on adding, now I know what permissions sets that my users have based on my user group. Or if not my user group section, then I could go into my individual users, as I showed you earlier, just a few minutes ago. And within my individual users, you'll see that they're assigned each user group based on my user roles, my user group permission sets. So that gives you an idea of how permissions are used. Thanks for watching. If we can further assist you, please reach out to us at epcgroup.net.